Hi everyone, I'm Lorenzo, and in this video I'm going to talk about all Tony Hawk games for the Sony PlayStation 2. So, the Tony Hawk games are marvelous games, whether you are into skating or not. The controls are easy to pick up, but difficult to master, and if you are familiar with Tony Hawk or you've ever seen a gameplay footage of a Tony Hawk game, you've seen how extreme the games can get, nailing sick combo moves across a map, and all of this awesomeness without breaking your neck in real life. In Tony Hawk, you create your own skater and get into multiple maps and roam free. That's right, you have free roam. But to unlock new maps, you have to talk to characters and do tricks. You have to complete their tasks, which are all fun. There are plenty of nice little details everywhere, you get unlockables, minigames, and the details are so many and to such an eye-watering level that the replay value of any of the games is astronomical. For example, to finish Pro Skater 4, you will need around 11 hours. But believe me, if you're like most people that played the game, 11 hours of gameplay is a joke. You'll play way more than that. You'll want to replay and roam the maps more and more, and even more after you've finished all of the tasks the game gives you. The maps are large and nicely done, so that you could, for example, chain a combo moves across the whole map. There are ramps, pipes, half pipes and rails everywhere, and even crazy details, like for example in Pro Skater 4 in the zoo levels, you can sketch behind a pooping elephant, or run away from a lion. And these are just two tasks from one map, from one game. Multiply this with the big amount of maps you get per game and the many Tony Hawk games you get, and the fun and originality shine like this bald guy's head. For example, as differences between them, we could count for example that from Tony Hawk Underground you could get off your board, which is cool, because in the previous games you couldn't. Also, Tony Hawk Underground is the first game that actually has a story. In the other ones you had just tasks to do, which had somewhat of a narrative, but in Underground it's a solid story this time, which is nice. Not to give spoilers, I'll tell you just this. In Underground the story is about you and your brother and drug dealers. In Underground 2, for example, they improved the graphics, added the slow motion ability, and they made the game crazier. Underground 1, with its story, had a more serious approach. But Underground 2 is just crazy. You are kidnapped by Tony Hawk and the gang and go into a world destruction tour around the world. You even chase down Bigfoot. And in American Wasteland, you get a story again, just like any Tony Hawk game after Underground. This time, you want to gather parts to build a park called the American Wasteland. So you roam LA, cause trouble, destroy stuff while skating on it, just to gather your materials. And the game is as crazy as the other ones. And in American Wasteland, you even get the feature to ride bikes and do tricks with the bikes. Also, the games have the create a park option. From Underground they added the create a trick option, and with each installment the character creation and board customization options get better and better. Till you get to Project 8, which has far less character customization options. You don't get the create a park option, nor you get the create a trick option, and this goes on to all the other games I will tell you about in this video. In Tony Hawk Project 8, for example, you get the nail the trick option, where when you hit the two joysticks, you get into slow motion and get to do tricks. And it's nice that the version is still comparable to the Xbox 360 and PS3 versions. It has downgraded graphics and many buffer zones where the game can load, which are sometimes annoying, but you still get one big map like in the new generation consoles. It's the same map but changed in some areas to make the game load easier. But it's still nice that you get the big map. And in Proving Grounds, you get, in addition to nail the trick option, the nail the manual option, which is the same thing but with manuals, and you'll get competitions with nail the trick and nail the manuals. Also, here you get some create a park option, as the game lets you put objects on the map how you wish. And you can also crawl, which isn't exciting, it's just annoying many times. And it has some new challenges that aren't as fun as crazy as the older games, but well, they exist. The only exception to the awesome games is Tony Hawk Downhill Jam, which doesn't have free roam. You just race downhill and get to do tricks. You get different tracks to go downhill and you can kick people. But not having free roam in a Tony Hawk game sucks. And the game is just racing. You don't really do much else in the game. You don't even have the option to have exhibition races. You just do the boring story missions. Even the story is awful. So I don't recommend you Downhill Jam, but I recommend you all the other games. They are awesome. Okay, so this was the video. If you liked it, please hit the like button and subscribe. If you want to support me in my pursuit to review as many video games as possible, click the join button and choose one of the perks. If you want, you can follow me on Twitch, Instagram or Discord. I've left the links to those in the video description. And if you want to see another video of mine, just wait till I stop talking and there will be thumbnails of other videos I've made. Thanks for watching.